Students, our today's topic of unit 4 is DC to DC converter. Okay, now in previous unit we have discussed the phase control rectifier which provide a variable DC voltage at their output. So here DC to DC converter is an alternate way to get a variable DC voltage. Okay, so we will see what is the chopper. So chopper is what? Chopper is a switch, or we can say the chopper circuit is used to convert a fixed DC voltage at their input into a variable DC voltage. Okay, so it is also known as a DC to DC converter, right? Now see the block diagram. This is the block diagram. You can see this is the chopper circuit. Input will be a fixed DC voltage, and at the load, that means output will getting a variable DC voltage. Okay, now chopper is what? Already told, chopper is a basically a switch which connects the load across the DC input supply. Okay, which can connect and disconnect also the load across the DC input supply. Okay, now we can use any type of switching devices like SCR, power BJT, power MOSFET or IGBT. Okay, now if we are using a SCR, then it requires a commutation circuit to turn off the SCR. Okay, now due to switching action, means it is connecting and disconnect the load. So due to switching action, the voltage across the load is a rectangular waveform. Okay, now you can see here it is the basic configuration of chopper. This chopper switch is connected with the input and the output. Okay, so this is what? This is the input. Input is fixed DC voltage we are giving to the chopper load. Okay, so this is the input, fixed DC voltage. Okay, and this one is the output. Here it is the output. So by switching action, the voltage across the load is a rectangular waveform. Okay, and by changing the on or off time, it is possible to change the average DC voltage across the load. Okay, now the load voltage waveform is rectangular independent of the type of load. Okay, if the load is inductive or resistive, the shape is same, that is rectangular. But in case of load current, the waveform depends on the type of load. For resistive load, the load current will have the rectangular shape and it is in phase with the load voltage. Okay, now the load current with the inductive load will be in exponential nature. Right, one more point is here that the load current can be continuous or discontinuous depending on the load inductance, on time of the chopper and magnitude of the load current. Okay, so this is basic of chopper. Now we will discuss the classification of chopper. Okay, so classification of chopper is known as what? It is also known as the DC transformer. We know that transformer classified as a step down transformer and step up transformer. Similar to transformer, the chopper also classified as step down and step up. Okay, again this step down chopper classified as a type A, okay, single cordon, type C, type D, two cordon and type E. So it is working four cordon. Okay, here type B chopper. Right, now what is meant by step down chopper? In step down chopper, the load voltage can be controlled between 0 and V. Okay, that means what? The output voltage can be most equal to the input. Okay, but in step up chopper, the load voltage can be higher than the input DC voltage. So this is the step down chopper and this one is the step up chopper. the step down chopper, the low voltage can be controlled between 0 and V. But in step up chopper, at the output we can get the higher voltage than the input DC voltage. Okay, so this is the classification. Now we'll discuss the control strategies. Right, now for all the chopper configuration operating from this fixed DC input voltage, the average value of the output voltage VLDC is controlled by periodic opening and closing of the switch used in the chopper circuit. Okay, so the average output voltage can be controlled by different technique as explained as follows. Okay, so first one is what? First one is the pulse width modulation. Second is what? Frequency modulation. Third one is what? Variable frequency, variable pulse width. And third, fourth is the CLC control. Okay, so here first we discuss the pulse width modulation. So pulse width modulation means what? Here, wait, this is the first pulse width modulation, that is PWM you can write. Here variable T1 and constant frequency. Okay, that means what? Frequency is constant but T1 time can vary. Okay, now in this strategy, the switches are turned on at a constant chopping frequency. Okay, so the on time of chopper is varied to vary the output voltage. Okay, what we are doing here, switches are turned on at a constant chopping frequency. And the on time of chopper is varied. Why? To vary the average output voltage. Now, the total period T of one cycle of output waveform is constant. Okay, time period is denoted by capital T. So, T is constant and we know that frequency f is equal to 1 of T. So, frequency is also constant. Now, the average output voltage is directly proportional to the on time of chopper. Okay. Now, duty cycle is equal to what? It is T1 upon T, where T is the T1 plus T off. Okay. So, the ratio of on time to the total time is defined as the duty cycle D. And it is given by D is equal to T1 upon T into 100%. Okay. So again, 1 upon T is nothing but frequency. So replace it. So you will get that equation D is equal to F into T1. Okay. So here, the duty cycle D can be varied between 0 and 1 or 0 to 100% or 0 to 1. Okay. Now we can explain it by waveform. Okay, so here you can see the two waveform here. Okay, so here the time period, that is time period for both the waveform is constant, that T is constant. Okay, but what we are changing, the time period is constant, frequency is constant. Okay, but what we are changing, we are changing the on time. Okay, so here on time is small, here on time is increases. Okay, so by comparing these two waveform, you can say that increase in on time, okay, or increase in duty cycle, we will increase the average load voltage VLDC. Okay, so you can see here, this is here the average output voltage is less as compared to average output voltage of this waveform. Here the on time is more as compared to first one. Okay, thank you.